As the nation's leading statistical agency, your Census Bureau continuously evaluates and improves the methods by which we collect data. As scientists, demographers, and statisticians, we are obligated to ensure that all the information we provide to the nation is as accurate as possible. Since we deal with numbers on such a large scale, it is imperative we continuously check our work, because a small error in a large population can create an even larger error in a smaller related population. We recently came across this scenario when analyzing the number of same-sex couples in the United States. Let's take a look at how a mere mismarking on a form can result in an inaccurate count of a group within the population. A simple math equation can illustrate this. Let's say there are 1,000 circles and 100,000 squares, where each square and circle is the equivalent to 1,000. If just 1% of the squares are erroneously counted as circles, that's 1,000 squares now listed as circles. This mislabeling of squares would inaccurately represent the total number of circles by doubling their amount. Through this example, we can see the importance of accuracy. In our work, we know that the design of a form can affect how people answer the questions and even introduce errors into the process. A data capture error can happen when the human eye misreads or skips wording on a survey questionnaire. The Census Bureau takes this into account as we process responses and design our surveys. We learned from the 2007 American Community Survey that when boxes were placed like this, respondents or door-to-door census takers may accidentally mismark their gender because the eye is not registering all that is on the page. Additionally, a mere extension of a marked line may result in an erroneous response. A change in the placement of boxes can fix this. We found that moving the boxes from here to here almost completely eliminated these kinds of errors on the American Community Survey. We do extensive testing of how respondents' eyes track the information presented on the form. Upon further study of the 2010 census results, we discovered that a small percentage of enumerators erroneously recorded the gender of couples residing within some of the households surveyed. While we discovered this issue on the ACS form in enough time to make the necessary changes needed to the 2010 census form that was delivered to your home, the forms that the enumerators used when going door to door were unable to be corrected in time. So, how does this type of data capture error affect the number of same-sex couple results for the 2010 census? This graphic illustrates same-sex and opposite-sex couples. Let's say that a county has 1,000 same-sex couples and 100,000 opposite-sex couples. If just 1% of the opposite-sex couples are erroneously reported as same-sex couples, that's 1,000 additional couples now listed as same-sex. This mismarking results in responses that artificially inflate the number of recorded same-sex couples. Census Bureau staff developed another set of estimates to provide a more accurate way to measure same-sex couple households. The revised numbers, in addition to the original and the American Community Survey estimates, are now available. Providing the new set of estimates ensures that all groups within our population have an accurate representation so that we can better reflect who we are as a nation. Your Census Bureau is constantly evaluating data collection operations to better measure the nation's people, places, and economy.